see a lot of patients in the summer that come in with heat stroke, heat exhaustion. They've been out in the sun too long, haven't hydrated themselves. I recall two siblings actually that had been camping, and their parents brought them in and they just weren't acting correctly. It was already a stressful situation for the whole family, and then we have two children in here that were not feeling well.
One of the big things that people forget when they're out in the sun, even with the kids or out at the pool or even out at the lake, is to remember to drink. Not the sports drinks, not the local high-energy drinks that everybody's saying, oh, you need to be drinking these. I tell them, water, water, water. The signs and symptoms that they start looking for or they ignore is they get so hot, they forget to realize they're no longer perspiring. The sweat's gone. They've already gone to the past the point of, okay, I'm past heat.
It was very hard for the parents. You feel a personal responsibility for it.
Immediately we're looking for, are they breathing fast? Are they looking like they're dehydrated? Pale lips, dry mucous membranes, or eyes don't have that glisten to them. Do they have sweat on their forehead? Or are they past the point that they're just sitting there just kind of, oh my gosh, what's going on, in a dazed and confused look about them?
We got them IV fluids going, drew some lab work on them, made sure that we were making them as comfortable as possible.
Then we bring in the cooling blankets. We have the bear hugger, which is a really cool gown that goes on to the patient. We can add heat, but in this case, we don't want to add heat, so we add cool air, and it slows the patient's, brings down the patient's temperature slowly. Then we start bringing in sips of cool water, not ice water. We want cool water, so we don't want them to start vomiting at the same time, which can dehydrate the body faster and bring us back to the square one. We constantly monitor their vital signs. We make sure that their blood pressure is coming up instead of staying low or hypotensive. Then we watch their heart rate. We will run EKGs on them, which checks the electrical impulses of the heart to make sure that there's no effects on the heart that's going on as well.
So we got them hydrated up, and then once they started to perk up, then we could start giving them oral fluids, start to replace their hydration that way.
Usually the typical heat stroke patient does go home on the same day, depending on the severity of the symptoms. If they wait to the final stages where they are very out of it, we may keep them overnight just to make sure that there's no continuing damage.
And they ended up both doing well and left the ER just different children, just feeling much better.